A living trust is a common estate planning tool for transferring assets at death to children and other loved ones. One of the primary reasons trusts are used is to avoid having assets tied up in probate court. Another reason might be to minimize the amount of estate taxes owed upon death. However, one of the most important benefits of a trust is the ability to protect your assets from your children and from their creditors. Hello, I'm Chris Watkins, Vice President and Relationship Manager at Central Trust Company. A common estate plan might provide that upon your death, your assets will be distributed outright to your children. While that has the benefit of being simple, there can be risks with such a plan. First, the child may be immature or irresponsible with finances. In many cases, a child who receives a sizable inheritance will view it as a windfall rather than save the money for the future. Second, the child may have creditors. If a child owes money to a creditor and defaults on that debt, that child's assets are subject to being seized or attached by his or her creditors. To the extent a child receives an inheritance outright, it becomes fair game to his or her creditors. Third, the child may get divorced. In a divorce, a couple's marital assets are typically divided equally between the former spouses. While inheritance is considered a separate asset under most states' laws, it can easily be reclassified as marital property. A properly drafted trust can reduce those risks by limiting or delaying the distribution of assets to your children and putting control of distribution decisions in the hands of a qualified trustee. Sometimes family members are placed in this role, but a corporate trustee is usually much better suited to deal with the legal and fiduciary complexities involved and has the added benefit of avoiding family issues that can arise when one family member is put in control of another family member's inheritance. An important component is the existence of a spendthrift clause in the trust, which is a statutory protection in most states. Such a clause prevents a beneficiary from transferring their interest in the trust and prevents most creditors of the beneficiary from reaching the trust income or principal before it is distributed to the beneficiary. Of course, once trust assets are distributed out to the beneficiary, those assets become his or her property and thus are subject to creditors' claims. But until that occurs, a spendthrift clause provides very good protection. A trust can also help protect your assets from being given to your child's spouse in the event of a divorce. The reason is that the assets of a properly drafted trust remain segregated from your child's assets and out of his or her control, at least to the extent the trust assets have not been distributed to your child. Similarly, in the event your child dies and is survived by a spouse or children, with a trust, you can control the extent to which the assets are distributed to the surviving spouse or your grandchildren. Making a trust part of your estate plan, combined with the designation of a capable and qualified trustee and a spendthrift clause, can help ensure that after you are gone, your assets will be preserved and protected from your children, their creditors, and their ex-spouses. For more information on financial topics and the latest wealth-focused news, contact an advisor at Central Trust Company or visit our website at centraltrust.net.